Look, we're really excited to have closed. This is our Series B2 round, so $10 million. It was led by Global Innovation Fund, and some of our existing investors also came in. Goodwill West Africa, managed by Alethea, At Level, Omidyar Network, Unreasonable Capital, they're all in. This round will actually power the next big push for Paga, taking us into new markets. We're looking at international expansion, not only to Ethiopia, in Africa, of course, Mexico and the Philippines as well. We're going through the diligence right now, and we'll determine the key markets that we'll ultimately go into.
Now, some might say that, okay, why not conquer Africa first? Because, I mean, yes, there's a huge population here on the African continent. There's so many countries on the African continent mm-hmm. that need, they have the similar issues that we have in Nigeria. And so some might say, why not, I mean, expand your footprints in Africa first before venturing outside?
Well, the problems that exist in Nigeria and other parts of Africa also obviously exist in many other markets, right? Our purpose, our goal is to make it easy and make it simple for 1 billion people to access and use money, right? Focusing only on Nigeria obviously doesn't meet that need. Yeah. There are other parts of Africa where the need actually exists, but frankly, even in Asia, Latin America, other emerging markets, the same exact issue around payments, mm-hmm. around access to capital, around access to basic financial services exists. So the opportunity exists for Paga being a scalable platform, multi-currency, and it's a world-class platform that we can use anywhere. So again, it's about driving with partners to figure out which markets to push into first.
When you're figuring out the markets, you have those markets on your radar already, and you're probably doing market research now, looking at those markets.
Exactly. We've named some markets that are sort of high priority on our list, of great interest on our list. Ethiopia is one of them, okay. The Philippines, and then Mexico as well. But we're actually going through the deeper diligence right now. There are certainly other parts of Africa that may show up to be of great interest. But again, the growth is about, you know, reaching the mass market and getting to a lot of people as quickly as possible.
Obviously, you must also be thinking about, I mean, entry barriers into those markets that you're looking to. And I mean, I imagine there will be other similar fintech startups such as like Paga, who are also, you know, perhaps dominating that market for now. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I mean, is that something that you guys are, I mean, obviously maybe not worried about it, but would definitely be keeping an eye on that?
No, it's definitely something to consider. Keep in mind that as we think about all these markets, we're also thinking about it in terms of partnership as well, mm-hmm. right? So there are going to be banks, there are going to be other financial institutions, there are going to be other non-financial institutions that we could work with in these markets. But again, it's about, you know, quality of your platform and execution strategy, and we feel as if we have the right mix to actually win in whichever markets we choose.
Okay, speaking about execution, Paga, you took off in, what, 2012?
Yeah.
Commercial location, yeah, like exactly. 2012 or so. I mean, 6 years on, and it's bringing the total investment so far to $35 million US dollars. In terms of, I mean, value for money and how far you've gone in the journey to, I mean, meeting your big picture, providing, you know, those services to up to a billion people, how would you rate your performance so far and how far you've gone in achieving those goals?
Yeah, it's been. I would not say it's been easy, but we've made great, great progress to date, right? Our primary footprint has been in Nigeria to date. Today we have, this is 9 years in, we have 9 point something million users on the platform, 17,000 agents across Nigeria, and very, very quickly growing. We've transacted over $4 billion to date. I would say, you know, relatively speaking, we've done quite well. I would say in the industry space that we operate in, we're very likely at the top, or if not the top, mobile payments operator.
Okay, now at the heart of this is also financial inclusion.
Of course.
And of course, helping to bring in the unbanked and just giving people access, especially in an informal sector, access to financial services, of course, with the aid of banks. And I know that there's also the shared network program, but like I said, financial inclusion. But when we take a look at the financial inclusion numbers, those who still do not have access, numbers are still quite huge. So what are your thoughts in terms of how we're trying to close that gap? I mean, with companies like Paga, yeah. you know, government and other partners in the private sector, what are your thoughts?
You know, financial inclusion is something that really does motivate us. Today, as you very well know, in excess of 60 million plus people in Nigeria, adults in Nigeria, do not have access to financial services. So Paga, as a mobile payments operator, but also an operator of agent networks, has been at the forefront of pushing this. I'll say a large number of our customers today, if not the majority, are people that typically you would not find walking into bank branches, even though we serve both banked and the unbanked. Recently, and this has been in the news as well, the SANEF program led by the central bank and the bankers committee, has raised a new push to actually even penetrate deeper into markets where bank penetration is even lower. Mm-hmm. So in the Northwest and the Northeast, Paga is part of that program as well. So at our heart, financial inclusion is very, very key. The methods to achieve it, the things that, again, we need to continue to innovate on and invest mm-hmm. in. Agent network is one of them, and this investment will support growth of our agent network. But we're also driving out with, you know, use of the wallet. So the Paga platform has a wallet. And in fact, we just launched a new app, which is available for download on Android and iOS, that anybody can actually utilize to send money or request money for free. Okay. All these things are, you know, steps in that direction of making it easy for people to move money around and access cash.
Now, as a company, I know that it hasn't all been, you know, easy peasy. I know you're operating in this kind of business environment in the country. What would you say have been the biggest challenges for you, I mean, since inception?
The biggest challenges, I'll probably touch on two key areas. One is actually recruiting and retaining, you know, really strong talent. Our educational system doesn't necessarily produce, you know, always the highest quality candidates for certain jobs that we're targeting, because some of these industries are pretty new. At the same time, the same set of people that we're targeting for those roles within our company are being pulled by the banks, by the telecom companies, etc. So I'll say, you know, again, recruiting and managing and retaining that talent has been a tough piece. The second area I would actually point out to be, you know, around raising investment. Mm. Again, we're very fortunate to have very strong investors that support and have continued to support throughout, including the new Investor Global Innovation Fund. But it hasn't been easy. The depth of capital, or I would say venture capital and private equity in Nigeria, is not as deep as many other markets.